ओके चिल्ड्रन, सो कंटिन्यू विद एक्सरसाइज वी हैड स्टार्टेड यस्टरडे, दैट इज बेसिकली नाउ द एक्सरसाइज 1A. दिस इज रिविजन 5, विच चैप्टर लेसन 1. Okay, this was idea of sets. I think so. Yesterday I told till question number 5. Question 6 I'm taking now. Question 6 first part says that write the following sets in tabular form. Tabular form is which form? Tabular form is also called as the roster method. That means I have to write the elements. Now what the question says? Question says x such that x equal to n by n plus 1. Question says x such that x equal to n by n plus 1. And n is element of natural numbers and n is less than equal to 9. And n is element of, I have not written the question but in short I have written. So n is element of n and these are what? Natural numbers. Now see here. N by n plus 1 means what? Our first number will be, what does natural number starts from? 1. So first will be 1. 1 upon 1 plus 1. That means 1 upon 2. Yes or no? Then our second natural number, next will be what? 2. 2 upon 2 plus 1. That means 2 by 3. Yes or no? N upon n plus 1. What is small n? Small n is a natural number. And that means you have to move from the first natural number and do on n upon n plus 1. That means in this tabular method, only what we need to write is the elements of the set separated by commas. So you can write here, A is equal to, similarly what we write, n equal to 3, then 3 upon 3 plus 1, that means 3 by 4. Then 4 upon 4 plus 1, that means 4 by 5. Then 5 by 5 plus 1, that means 5 by 6. Till where? Till 9. Because n is less than equal to 9. So first element will be 1 by 2. Second will be 1 by 2. First is 1 by 2, then it is. This is 2 by 3. 2 by 2 plus 1, 2 by 3, 3 by 4, 4 by 5, 5 by 6, 6 by 7, 7 by 8, 8 by 9, and 8, but let it go in line, so comma, 9 by 10. How 9 by 10 has come? When n equal to 9, 9 upon 9 plus 1. So 9 upon 10. That is the answer of the 6th first part. This was exercise 1A, 6th first part. I am taking up the 5th part also from this one. I am wrapping this as of now. Question 5th part. Now see what is the 6th question 5th part? P such that P equal to 7n. That means P such that P is equal to 7m. Now what is m? There will be a description about m. M is an integer. M is an element of I. That means m is an integer. And minus 1 more than equal to m and less than equal to 3. So from minus 1 to 3, that means values of m will be from where? Minus 1, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. These all values of m are there. And what is m here? We put there. That means p equal to 7n. So the first value will be what? P is equal to 7 into minus 1. That will be 7 into 1. sorry, I have to place it the wrong way. Minus 1, order is not correct. Minus 1, then 0. Yes, minus 1, 0. Then 1, 2, 3. Minus 1, then 0. Then P is equal to 7 into 1. Then P is equal to 7 into 2. Then P is equal to 7 into 3. 7 to minus 1 is 7. Minus 7, here 0. Here 7. Here 14. Here 21. These are the values. So 6th and 5th part. So all your elements, let me connect from set like B is equal to. Elements of the set are what? Minus 7 first, then 0, then 7, then 7 to the 14, 7 to the 21. Children, if you can visualize here, only thing is that if you remove the integer part, this is basically a multiple of 7 only. But minus 1 and 0 will not be there. This is basically a table of 7. That way. Now, I think so these two parts are sufficient. Now, taking this question number 7. Two parts are taken from 7th also. I am taking 7th question. Second part. And 7th question, 5th part. Now, 7th question, 2nd part I am going. What is that? 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. See, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. What you have to do here? We have to write the set builder form. So, 3 is what? 3 into 1. 6 is 3 into 2, 9 is 3 into 3, 12 is 3 into 4, 15 is 3 into 5. That means, you see, 3 is common. That means, we can write x such that x equal to 3n. And children, elements are given 15. That means, n should be less than equal to 5 and more than equal to 1. And n is what? Natural number. These all things are there. Let's write. We'll write x such that x is equal to 3n. 3n by 3 is common and n is changing. X such that x equal to 3n. Comma, n is an element of natural numbers. And how does n vary? More than equal to, n is more than equal to 1 and less than equal to 5. That's it. So see, whenever the elements are given, you have to check that the elements are given this way. You have to just get the criteria which is defining all the elements, that connects all the elements. Rubbing this part now. One more part from 7:30. That's the 5th part. 5th part is what? Minus 24, minus 12, 0. Minus 24, minus 12, 0. 12, 24, 36, 48, 60. See here. Minus 24 is what? Can you say 12 into minus 2? This is 12 into minus 1. This is 12 into 0. This is 12 into 1. 12 into 2. 12 into 3. 12 into 4. 12 into 5. That means from minus 2 to 5 you have to generate numbers. That means n has to be an integer. So from where it will come? Minus 2 more than equal to n, less than equal to 5. And n is an element of integers. Let's see here. Again you write x such that x is equal to 12n, because 12 is getting multiplied everywhere. Then what? N is an element of integers. And how it is varying? It is varying like from minus 2 मोर देन इक्वल टू एन, लेस देन इक्वल टू फाइव, दैट शुड बी आवर आंसर। ओके, सो दिस पार्ट इज द एक्सप्लेनेशन थिंग। नाउ I am taking some questions from size 1B. This all is in revision only. Now, finite set or not? First question. I am taking the seventh part because it looks like a tough part. You have to tell us that the finite set or not. Without writing the elements, you cannot tell that. N minus 1 upon N, N is element of natural numbers and X equal to this. Now, what is the first natural number? 1. 1 minus 1 is by 1. That means 0 by 1. Next will be what? 2 minus 1 by 2. That means 1 by 2. Don't you feel there is no limit given? So it will keep on coming. So what the elements will be? First element will be 0, then 1 by 2, then what? 0 what? 2 minus 1? So 1, 2, 3. 3 minus 1 is 2. 2 by 3. Then 4 minus 1, 3. 3 by 4 and so on. Therefore, it is a infinite. Infinite or non-finite? Infinite set. That's it. So this was your first question, seventh part. Similarly, limits are given, they can see that. Then let me take another question. Question number 2. Question 2 is what? Question 2 says, let the universal set U and A is given. Write A by the Rousseau method. So let's see what U will be. U is what? See, universal set U is 1, 2, 3, sorry, multiple of 3 and between 0 and 37. So multiple of 3 means 3, 6, 3 is a 9, 3 4 is a 12, 3 is a 15, 3 6 is a 18, 3 7 is a 21, 3 is a 24, 3 is a 27, 3 7 is a 30, 3 is a 33, 3 12 is a 36. 3 12 is a 36. That means this is the U is universal set. The question says U is equal to a multiple of 3 between 0 and 37. So more than 0 and less than 37. Then what is A? A is a multiple of 6. X is an X is a multiple of 6. 6 means 6, 12, 6 is a 18. Six is 34, 6 is a 30, 6 is a 36, 6 is a 42, and so on. A is an infinite set. Because they have not told what is the limit for A. So A is an infinite set. Then what they are saying? Write A by the Rousseau method. I think so this we have written. But see what the three are saying. They are assuming that A is a set which is coming from this. Okay, the light here. Since A is a subset of B, therefore by the definition A will be like this, but A has to be a subset of B. Yes or no? So since A is a subset of B, therefore what A will be? That means not B here, here U. Here U. So A is a subset of the universal set U. So therefore elements which are there in U only will be contained here. So what are elements are there which are there in U and that should be in A? 6 will be there, 12, 18, then 24, then 30 and 36. Okay, so whenever a universal set is given, the U has to be a part of the subset has to be a part of the universal set only. That's why it's given there. Okay. I'm loving it now. Then I'm taking the question number 4th first part. It is saying let R equal to letters of the word apple. R is equal to letters of the word apple. Apple means A P. Repeated will not write. L and E. These are the letters of the word apple. S equal to letters of the word pale. Pale, that means P A L E. Find the cardinality of the sets R and S. Cardinality means cardinal number. So N of R is equal to what? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 will be there. Cardinality of S, that means N of S will be what? 4 only. And what they are saying? They are saying, are the sets equivalent sets? Like here, since N of R is equal to N of S, therefore they are equivalent because of the cardinal number criteria. But see, don't you feel that if you change the order also, P is here also, L is here also, E is here also, and A is here also. Also then, right? Also, since every element of R is in S and every element of S is in R, therefore R and S are equal sets. That means they are equal also and equivalent also, both the things. So they are equal also and equivalent also. So what is right? R is equal to S and R is equal to S. Both the things are holding true. Correct? Let us quote first part for you. Then what? True, false. See, 2, 5 is given. Fifth first part. 2,5 is given. Is that a subset of this one? 2, 15, 3, 5. See here, 2, 5 are there. So it is a subset. That means this is true. What is? This belongs to this, so it is true. I think for many parts also you can go on your own. Then sixth question, lot of subparts are there. P is given 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. P is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yes, 9. Then Q is 2, 3, 4. R is 4, 5, 8. What are they saying? What are true? Now see, 2, 3, 4 is here. 2 is here? No. 3 is here? No. 4 is here? 4 only is there. That means Q is not belonging to this, but 4, 5, 8. That means we can say that R is a subset of P. Certainly. That means sixth, the third part should be true. This is the part, sixth, third part is true. See here. This 4 is here, 5 is here, 8 is here. So the all the elements of R are in P. That means R is basically a subset of P. That is true. Then one more part you see. Now see, what is N of Q? That means cardinal number of Q, 3. Cardinal number of R is also 3. Don't use their equivalent. So we write Q is equivalent to R. This is which part? Sixth part. So sixth part is also true. I hope this makes things clear. Then what? Next I am taking is 7th question, subsets. 7th question I am taking which part? I will take the second part. Seventh question, second part. Many people had issues that sir, my work is not complete, this and all these things. So, I am solving almost all questions. B is equal to 3, 6, 9. How many elements are there? 3. So how many subsets will be there? 2 to the power n. That means 2 to the power 3. That means 8. Let us see. Subsets of B. 3, 6, 9. Then 3, 6, 3, 9. Then 6, 9. Then 3, 6, 9 itself also will be a subset, and then 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So see, this is coming from where? Since every set is a subset of itself and 5 is a subset of every set. Mind it the same subsets. So second part I have done. Then 8th question. 8th question is saying what? Letters of the word 1. None. This is on the same pattern. You can do it on your own. Like later. Now, I am taking one question, some child has said. This question was, revision 6, N73, page N73, आई थिंक सो आलोक और अभ्यू अब सम नंबर सर वॉज देयर एन 33 क्वेश्चन 3 एक्सरसाइज 5C ये आस्क वन क्वेश्चन दैट इज माय कंक्लूडिंग क्वेश्चन दिस क्वेश्चन वॉज थर्ड पार्ट थर्ड क्वेश्चन ए प्लस ए इज इक्वल टू बी नाउ सी हियर वी हैव टू चेक हियर दैट व्हाट इज द नंबर दैट इफ वी एड टू इटसेल्फ विल गिव एट द वंस प्लेस ए यू चेक इट आउट हियर वन प्लस वन विल गिव व्हाट थ्री दैट मीन्स इट इज नॉट गिविंग यू वन इटसेल्फ सिमिलरली इफ यू चेक फोर प्लस फोर It is what? 12. So here 2 is coming. That is not, so this will not be correct. Similarly, if you check 5 plus 5 plus 5, 5 plus 5 plus 5 is what? 15. Now you can see you can get the ones place 5. That means 5 is what? So A will be 5. So if you add 5 plus 5 plus 5, you will get 15. 1 will be here. So right here, BA equal to Not like this. What you like, you'll add here. You'll add here. Since 5 plus 5 plus 5 is equal to 15. Therefore, A is equal to 5. And comparing 15 equal to B5, 1 equal to B. That's the answer. One last question, many things were there in this. Seventh question I'm taking up from exercise 5B. No, not seventh, I'll take some other question. I'll take fifth question. This type of questions also are there. For what value is the digit Z? So it is given 7, 9, ZA is divisible by which number? 9. Now what is the divisibility of 9? If the sum of digits is divisible by 9, then the number will be divisible by 9. Let us see here. Right. Sum of digits. Z is the single digit number. Sum of digits. 7 plus 9 plus Z plus 8. It how much it is? 9, 7, 16, 16, 4, 20, and 24. 24 plus Z. Now, what is the nearest number that you can get? 24, 25, 26, 27. For 24 plus Z to be divisible by 9, it should be equal to a multiple of 9. So that means 24 plus Z, the closest multiple you can get is what? 27? Therefore Z will be equal to what? 27 minus 24, that means how much? 27 minus 24 is 3. Let's see what the answer is. Okay, 3 only. You can solve many questions on the same pattern.